In this video, we'll cover more features relating to transformations, the object pivot, alignment, and matching transformations. Note that we're using Maya 2015 Extension 1 for this video because it's got an updated Edit Pivot tool, which we'll look at here. For information about using pivots in Maya 2015, see the video Understanding Snapping and Pivots in Maya on this channel. One fundamental feature that you'll find different between Softimage and Maya is the object pivot. In Softimage, there are actually three types of pivots: the center, the object pivot, and the tool pivot. Centers are like permanent pivots that define an object's position in space and act as the default pivot. In center manipulation mode, you can transform the object center. The object's vertex positions in world space remain where they are, but their local positions are updated to compensate for this offset. Object pivots are in the same location as the center by default, but you can offset them from the center. In addition to transforming object pivots, you can also animate them, which you can't do with centers. Tool pivots are like temporary pivot points in space that you can use while you're working. Just press the Alt key while you reposition the pivot, then rotate or scale around this point. You can also modify the object pivot with the Alt key if the Transform Modify Object Pivot option is on. In Maya, the object pivot is most like Softimage's object pivot. It defines an object's location in space and provides the pivot point for transformations. There's no center manipulation mode in Maya, but you can offset the pivot from the object center using the Edit Pivot tool. Open the Tool Settings panel for a transformation tool and click the Edit Pivot button or press the Insert key. In the Attribute Editor, you can see how the position values for the object's pivot are updated when you move the pivot manipulator. Maya's object pivot is actually made of two separate pivots, the Rotate Pivot and the Scale Pivot, which are in the same location by default. If you want to numerically change the position values for the pivots, you can use the boxes here. Note that these are values in the object's local space. The World Rotate and Scale Pivots attributes define each of the pivot's values in global space, which can be useful when you're animating the pivot, as we'll cover later. When you rotate the Edit Pivot manipulator, you automatically switch to the Custom Axis Orientation mode for the current transformation tool. You can also numerically set the values for the custom orientation here. To move the pivot back to the center of the object's bounding box while you're in Edit Pivot mode, right-click and choose Reset Pivot, or reset its orientation and position separately. You can also click the Reset button, which resets both position and orientation, like the Reset Pivot command. When you have the pivot the way you want, press the Insert key or click Edit Pivot again to return to the previous Transform tool. Then you can transform the object using this new pivot point. At any point, you can choose Modify Center Pivot to return the pivot to its original position, but not its orientation, or click the Reset button to reset both. If you want to use the Edit Pivot tool in Super Mode, hold down the D key while you move and rotate the pivot as you want, then release the key. The Edit Pivot tool also works with selected components on an object. For example, you can select some faces, press the D key and move the pivot, release the D key, then scale the faces using that pivot. You can also use the Adjust Pivot tool in the Modeling Toolkit for transforming components. This tool also uses the D hotkey. Let's go back to the Tool Settings panel. An important thing to note here is that, like the other transform modes, the Custom Orientation mode is set for the Transform tool and not the object itself. This means that you can have only one custom orientation per transform tool. So how do you create a more permanent pivot change for an object since Maya doesn't have an equivalent of Softimage's center mode? One way is to create a locator that will act as the object's pivot and adjust its position and orientation. To make the locator a part of a hierarchy, make it a child of the parent node. And then make the object which will use the locator as a pivot a child of that locator. This works for simple objects as well as for hierarchies. Just make sure to parent each object under its locator to have a permanent pivot for it. Similar to the object pivot in Softimage, you can animate the object pivot in Maya. We'll show how to do the classic rolling cube as an example. The pivot has several channels that are not keyable by default, so they don't show up in the channel box. To expose these channels, choose Edit Channel Control in the channel box. Select the Rotate Pivot Translate and Rotate Pivot channels from the non-keyable hidden list and move them to the keyable list. This is similar to how you make parameters keyable in the keying panel in Softimage. Move the pivot to the cube's edge at the bottom. Set a key for the cube's Rotate Z channel at frame 1. Then go to another frame, rotate the cube in Z, and set a key there. Return to frame 1, select the pivot channels, and set a key with these values. At the next keyframe, open the attribute editor and set the world rotate pivot value so that it lines up with the edge of the cube. This moves the pivot in global space. You can't key these pivot attributes directly, but setting their values affects the pivot channel values that we exposed in the channel box. Select all these channels and set a key at this frame. You can continue with these steps of keying the cube's rotation, setting the world rotate pivot values, and keying the pivot channels. The animation looks a bit weird right now because the pivot needs to snap from one position to the next. To do this, open the graph editor, select the pivot curves, and choose Tangents Stepped. And make sure that the cube's rotation curve is linear. Now the animation should look correct. In addition to the default pivot tools in Maya, you can check out the pivot-related bonus tools, which you may find useful for specific issues. In Stephen Rosell's video, Maya Bonus Tools 2015, What's New?, he covers the different zero pivot tools, in addition to some snapping and alignment tools. Speaking of snapping, let's move on to that. An important snap tool is the Make Live tool, which makes any object act like a magnet to which you can snap selected objects. There is no transformation mode in Maya like the Ref or Plane modes in Softimage. But you can use the Make Live tool with a construction plane or any other object you like to constrain an object to move or scale in its direction. Choose Create Construction Plane options to set it up. And position and rotate the plane as you want. Then click the Make Live icon or choose Modify Make Live. Select the object you want to have snap to the construction plane and open the Move tool settings. Change the transform mode to Along Live Object Axis, and the object's pivot aligns to the construction plane's pivot. You can then move or scale the object with the same orientation as the live object. Make sure to deactivate Make Live and switch back to another transform mode when you're done. For other types of alignment, Maya provides a couple of handy tools. You can use the Align Objects tool to set up a custom alignment, which is similar to the Align Objects command in Softimage. Remember that alignment always happens in terms of the object pivot. The Snap Together tool is another handy tool that lets you align objects with interactive control. You can open the Modify Snap Together tool options to set up if you want to move and rotate the object, or just move it. Click a point on the object that you want to snap to another object. Then click a point on the object to which you want the first object to snap. Little blue arrows appear showing where the objects will snap together. You can drag the arrows around before you decide on a final position. When you have the arrows where you want them, press Enter to snap the objects together. For more information about other Align tools, see the video Pivots and Alignment in Maya on this channel. In addition to the standard alignment tools in Maya, there are some bonus tools that you may find useful. As described in Stephen Rosell's video, Maya Bonus Tools, Orient Tool. Some Softimage tools for alignment that you'll probably want to recreate in Maya are the different match tools. One way to reproduce match position and match orientation is to use the parent constraint, which matches the object's position and or orientation, but no scaling. Select the object you want to use for matching. We're just using a simple locator. Then press Shift and select the object you want to constrain to the first object, and choose Constrain Parent. Then choose Constrain Remove Target to undo the constraint, leaving the object in this location. You can also run this script in the script editor to do the same thing in one shot. If you want to match each transformation separately, you could use the point, orient, and scale constraints individually. You can run these scripts to use and remove each constraint individually, or run them all to reproduce the match transform command. And of course, you can add these scripts to a custom shell for easy access. And then use them on any objects you like. This video wraps up the basics for transformations and pivots in Maya. In the next videos, we'll look at ways of organizing the data in your Maya scene.